FCFS. In FCFS, children, what will happen? The process which comes first, that will be executed first if all the processes arrive at the same time. Let's explain this FCFS kernel with the help of an example. Let's say that there are four processes, P1, P2, P3 and P4. The arrival time in milliseconds of these processes are, say, process P1 arrived at time 0, process P2 arrived at time 1, process P3 arrived at time 2 milliseconds, and process P4 arrived at the time 3 milliseconds. If the execution time of these processes in milliseconds, say execution time of process P1, it is 8 milliseconds. Process P2, it is say 7 milliseconds. Process P3, say it is 5 milliseconds. And process P4, say it is 2 milliseconds. So this example is clear. There are how many processes? 4 processes. P1, P2, P3 and P4. The arrival time of these processes are 0 millisecond, 1 millisecond, 2 millisecond and 3 millisecond. The execution time of these processes are 8 millisecond, 7 millisecond, 5 millisecond and 2 millisecond. Now question arises, if the system is using FCFS kernel, then what will be the sequence of execution of these processes? What will be the structure of Gantt chart? And what will be the computation values of response time, turnaround time and waiting time? So these things we can explain with the help of Gantt chart. So if we are drawing the Gantt chart, so initially, what is the initial time, what is the starting time of the processes? Starting time of the process, it is 0. So let's see, as per this example, at time 0, how many processes are there? Only one process, that is process P1. Because arrival time of process P2 is 1 millisecond. So at time 0, only one process, that is process P1, is there. It means that the execution of process P1, it will start at time 0. And remember, FCFS, what type of algorithm is this? This is a non-preemptive. Non-preemptive means if a process P1 gets the CPU, then process P1, it will leave the CPU when? Okay. Only after finishing its execution. How much time process P1 needs for execution?
8
milliseconds. It means at time 0, when process P1 got the CPU, then process P1, it will leave the CPU at 8 milliseconds. So at 8 milliseconds, process P1, it will finish its execution. So F is representing finish execution time of process P1. So let's see, at 8 milliseconds, what's the scenario? Process P1 finished execution. How many processes are there? P2, P3 and P4. So we are talking about which algorithm? First come first serve. So out of the processes P2, P3 and P4, which process came first? It was P2. It means that at 8 milliseconds, when execution of process P1 is over, the execution of process P2, it will be started. Again, I am speaking. This is the non-preemptive schedule. FCFS is non-preemptive schedule. It means when process P2, it will get the CPU at 8 milliseconds. So process P2, it will leave the CPU only after finishing its execution. So if we see the execution time of P2 is 7 milliseconds. It means at the time 15 milliseconds, process P2, it will finish the execution. So see the scenario. At 15 milliseconds, process P1 finishes the execution, process P2 finishes the execution. So how many processes are left?
Two
processes, P3 and P4. So out of P3 and P4, which process will be executed first? Since process P3 came at 2 millisecond time and process P4 came at 3 millisecond time, therefore process P3 will be executed first, because the arrival time of process P3, it is prior to the arrival time of process P4. It means at the time 15 milliseconds, process P3, it will be executed, and in the process P3 it needs how much time? 5 milliseconds. It means from 15 milliseconds to 20 milliseconds of time, process P3, it will be executed. And at the time 20 milliseconds, process P3, it will finish execution. And finally, only one process is left, that is process P4, means at the time 20 milliseconds, process P4 will start execution, and at the time 22 milliseconds, process P4, it will finish execution. If once this one is figure 2,